I updated my profiles for Cura 4.6.1 and I found a neat little trick to make your own logo on the bed in Cura. I'll show you all the details on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. I've been using my 4.5 profiles in Cura 4.6 and they've been working fine, but it gave me an opportunity to upgrade just a little bit because one of the biggest complaints that I got from my profiles is they print really good, especially small, but as the print got bigger, they take too long. Was there a way to speed it up? So I actually found just some minor adjustments throughout the whole profile and it helped speed things up quite a bit. Let me show you how much faster it got. I'm using Cura version 4.6.1 and I've loaded in a CHEP cube and I'm going to use my version 4.5 profile, the best profile, 0.12 layer height. When I slice it, it says 1 hour and 9 minutes to print it. Now let's try my new one, the 4.6 version. When I slice it, 57 minutes. So it's not a big difference, but it is quicker. Now let's look at the 0.28. The 4.5 is 35 minutes. The 4.6 version, when I slice that, 22 minutes, so a lot quicker there. But now when you get bigger, let's upsize this thing to 200%. Now let's see the difference. 4.5 sliced, 6 hours and 23 minutes. 4.6 sliced, 4 hours and 48 minutes, almost 2 hours quicker. Now let's try the 0.28. In this one, I made some major changes. 3 hours and 11 minutes at the 4.5, 1 hour 33 minutes with 4.6. As you can see, these new profiles print a lot faster, and I'll show later in the video that the quality is still really good. The next improvement I made is related to material temperature. The way I did it before is I kind of locked the temperature in. You had to manually change it if you changed from, say, PLA to PETG. Well, there's a drop down within Cura to change that, and it should automatically change the material temperature and bed temperature and things like that. Well, I fixed that. Let me show you. I have my 4.5 best profile selected and the temperature is 205 degrees C. Now I'll show you how this locks in, because if I come up here and select a different material other than PLA, such as PETG, when I select it, the temperature doesn't change. The color of the block changes to show it's a different material, but the temperature doesn't change. That's the part that's broken. So in 4.6, let me show you how I fixed it. So I'll select 4.6 and do the same thing. I'll go from PLA, which is now showing 200, and I'm going to select PETG, which should be 240. And so I'm going to select PETG, and it changes color and also changes temperature to 240. The bed changes to 80 degrees. So that's fixed. Another request was to fix gaps that some people saw in their prints. And I did occasionally see it in a CHEP cube where there'd be a gap, like around the Z, so it's the top surface. So I went back and looked at my settings for that, and there definitely was room for improvement. Let me show you. If I open 4.5 again and then just search for overlap, there's several boxes that aren't checked and some values that really weren't perfect. So let's go back to 4.6 and I'll select that. And now you'll see it changes here. All these compensate wall overlaps are now checked. The 10% stayed, but I went to a 30% overlap for infill, and all this seemed to help a lot. You can see on the left the 4.5 and on the right the improved 4.6. When Cura moved from version 3.6 to 4.0, they changed the formatting. So my 3.6 profiles wouldn't work, I had to make new ones. And when I did that, I used the Creality machines to do it. Well, it had Creosome in it, so it changed a lot of the labeling for the different layer heights, which was in conflict with other printers. So if you tried to load my profiles into Cura and you didn't have a Creality machine selected, you would get an error. Now there are ways to modify the files and some people have sent me modifications, but I'm still getting errors sometimes with those files. So what I basically did is I made two versions. I now have a profile for machines that are non-Creality and a profile for machines that are Creality. Until I can work this out consistently, that's what I'm going to use. So let me show you that. Let me select a printer other than a Creality Ender 3. Let's pick the G-Tech A10. It's a very similar printer. I'll go to Manage Profiles, and then I'll import. And I'll try to import my 4.6.2 layer height. I'll open it, and you get this error message. It doesn't like the quality type of standard. So I made separate profiles. So here's the ones that don't require Creality. And look, it loaded just fine. So if you have a different machine than a Creality, just use these other profiles. I'll link to them in the description below. With the new 4.6 profile, I printed quite a few things. I'm pretty happy with the results. There's always room for improvement, but here's some of the results that I got. Here's some CHEP cubes that I printed a different size at a 0.12 profile. I like the results. Here's a benchy, pretty smooth, not perfect, but real close. And then I printed my CHEP pawn with the seam set to random, and it's very smooth all the way around. And then, of course, I had to reprint the Iron Man statue. I love this print. I also learned this trick how you can change the logo inside the bed of Cura. Let me show you how to do it. Here you can see my Filament Friday logo in the bed. So here's how you do it. You make a STL file. I did it in Tinkercad. And I made it 215 by 200 and only 0.1 millimeters tall. That's the trick. And then you save that as just an STL file. And then you go into the package contents or the file contents in Windows. And you go to Resources. Now on Mac, it's Resources again. Otherwise, you go into Meshes. And this is where you place that STL file. And then you're going to leave this and then go to Definitions. I showed you this in a previous video. Go to the Ender 3 Definition file. And there's one line in here that says Platform. Change that platform file from Ender 3 to FilamentFriday.stl or whatever your file is, and then save it. And then when you boot up, it's going to show your logo. I'm always making minor changes to my profiles, but this is where they're at right now. Download them, try them out, and let me know how they work for you in the comments below. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the videos that are popping up. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.